So I was sent some bits from a company called routercutter.co.uk, which, as of December 2016, January 2017, is a relatively new company. They supply CNC router bits here in the UK and Europe, stocking American and Italian made cutters. They've supplied me with 4 Whiteside carbide engravers, which I'd like to learn how to use. And I'll be doing this on my original belt driven CNC machine, as I'm still working on the controller for the lead screw machine. So the bits I've received are as followed. A 22 degree carving liner, which is model number SC50. A 30 degree engraving pencil point, model number SC70. The point cutting roundover bit, model number SC1568. And a 15 degree engraving bit with a flat point, SC54. So what do these bits do? When it comes to engraving, I've only ever used 60 and 90 degree carbide tipped V-bits, the sort you get with a hand router, which I've used to do some engraving such as the Guernica drawing. The material was a little bowed, or maybe my wasteboard was not entirely level, so you can see the lines are a little thicker to one side. I suspect I can do intricate and smaller engravings using the more acute angle of the 22 degree carving liner and the 30 degree pencil point. But I've not used anything like the point cutting roundover bit or the 15 degree flat point engraver, so I'm curious to see their effects. Anyway, before I start, I need to input the tool details into my software's tool database. I'm going to try some simple lettering on a scrap piece of red velcro mat from G-code created in ArtCam Express 2015. I used the carving liner and pencil point, but quickly noticed I could not control the feed rate. CNC is never straightforward. When I've prepared files in the past, I normally export the vectors as SVG files and cut them in Easel where I can set the feed rate. This time I was running G-code directly through Easel and the feed rate was maxed out, only limited by the maximum allowable feed rate in the gerbil firmware itself. What does that mean? The G-code was set to 30,000 mm a minute in the file I exported, but was limited to 3,000 mm a minute, which is still way too fast. Anyway, if you're wondering why I'm writing What You're Doing Sava, I haven't got YouTube fever. Have a listen to this voice message from my niece.
What are you doing, Sava? What are you doing, Sava?
Wait for it.
What are you doing, Sava?
So back to the video. I'm applying the various tools to the lettering to see how the paths manifest. The lower angle of the 22 degree carving liner means it needs more passes to route a deeper channel than compared to the 30 degree pencil point. For some reason the software wouldn't let me carve lettering using the roundover bit, so that tool's sidelined for beading work, unless I fool the tool database into thinking it's something else. The other thing I noticed was the flat point of the SC54 engraver made it almost impossible to use when doing smaller carving. That bit seems to lend itself to block lettering like that used on a printing press. Carving from the outside of the vectors could be useful to make stamps or printing blocks, and the 15 degree bevel it leaves would also make a good releasable surface to take moulds from or do vacuum forming. I'm just highlighting the area which would be rough cleared with a 1/4 inch bit and the detailed work of a flat point engraver. The first thing I have to do, however, is work out how to control the feed rate, otherwise I might break a bit and will not get the best finish on the material I'll be working on. I suspect I have to edit this information manually in a text document. There are some different parameters to G-code, and I think a few programs such as VCarve and Fusion 360 have post editors which prepare the G-code for the machine you will be cutting it on, in my case a gerbil machine. Annoyingly, ArtCam Express doesn't have a plugin for gerbil, and there seems to be very little support for the older versions of their software, especially since they've gone with an expensive subscription-only software. Using the copy and paste tool in WordPad, I have changed the feed rate to 600 mm/s and the plunge rate to 150 mm/s. This should help make for a cleaner cut. So what I'm going to do now is export some G-code and cut something for each of these 4 bits and show you the outcome. Here I've used the carving liner to engrave some small lettering. It works well on text up to 4 mm tall, and when limiting the tool depth to 1 mm. Because of the 22 degree angle above a certain size of lettering, the bit plunges a little too deep and the lettering looks a bit odd. I also had some problems with parts of the lettering chipping, but this is due to a combination of my feed rate and the material I'm cutting. The pencil point has a slightly larger angle, which means engraving lettering looks a little better, and this works well on lettering a little larger than that used with the carving liner. That said, limiting the tool depth can produce a better finish when cutting smaller lettering. As I mentioned before, I couldn't cut lettering out using the roundover bit, so I cut a simple border, which could be used to frame engravings. This also looked quite good on the denser velcro mat. The last bit was a flat bottom engraver with a 15 degree bevel. Because of the flat bottom or tip, the tool wouldn't be able to reach the crevices of smaller lettering and engravings, so I decided to cut some block lettering instead. I used a roughing tool path with a 1/4 inch bit to make the job a little quicker, cutting from the outside of the vectors and finishing with the flat bottom engraver. This was by far the most interesting effect when producing lettering. So to conclude, how I imagine using these bits in the future. I think I'll use the carving liner to do smaller detailed work, but in particular, translating drawings into toolpaths. The pencil point will work better with doing lettering because its angle suits itself better to that task. I'll use the roundover bit to do beading and border work, and the flat point engraver to make larger block lettering. Thanks again to routercutter.co.uk for supplying these bits to me. Their details will be in the description below. I'll also add, if you want to do some V-carving yourself, you don't need to get expensive software. You could use something like Scorchworks, F-Engrave, and I'll provide a link to that as well in the description.